All right. Hey, hey, Mitch, how you doing? Hey,
Alex, I'm doing well. Thanks all for asking. How are you?
I'm doing great. You're here to talk about my favorite subject of all time, package management, here in Visual Studio Team Services.
Fantastic. So I'm really interested to hear what you've been working on from a package management point of view. So can you tell us a little bit about how the service has been evolving?
Yeah, so we love listening to customer feedback. If you've ever filled out a developer community ticket or come to our user voice, visualstudio.uservoice.com, we love hearing that feedback. We take it in and we really do try to listen and improve. And some of the things we heard from customers were really interesting. Things like, you'll help me tell people when new versions of my package are available. Like, make it more of a push model. Send me an email. Tell me, hey, I made something new and you can consume it. Making it easier also for people to use packages from what we call upstream sources, so places like NuGet.org and npm.js, but in ways that I can kind of configure, control in my organization, have a better understanding so it's not just the Wild West of pulling in any open source that I want. And then even some basic things like, hey, I publish a lot of packages and sometimes I want to clean them up. I don't want to look at the package I produced 6 months ago. So we've added things like retention policies to make that easier as well.
Wow, you've been pretty busy. So you covered a bunch of things there. So what do you want to show us first?
Yeah, so I think we'll dive right into helping users keep up to date with packages that you create. And there's really two different ways we've made to do that. The first we're going to look at is just package notifications. So if you're a VSTS user, you've probably seen the notification settings hub before. If I just go up to my face, we'll do notification settings here. And then as soon as that pops up, we'll just make a new subscription. This will look pretty familiar to anyone who's used kind of any of the other subscriptions in VSTS.
Okay, so you've plugged into the built-in notifications system within VSTS.
Exactly. So the notifications look the same. You can unsubscribe from them the same if you decide that we've sent you too many. Kind of all that goodness.
Excellent.
Right. So I'm going to click New Subscription, and then we'll see kind of just alongside all the other features, the build, you know, code, whether you're using Git or TFVC, we have package management here at the bottom. And now I can see I want to be notified whenever a package is changed.
Okay.
Right. And so great. It's going to deliver to my preferred email address. I can also deliver to another email if I want that. And it's going to pop in some filter criteria here. And so the key with these notifications is I can do really as much or as many notifications as I want or as few. Okay. So in this case, let's take your AdventureWorks feed. So let me go ahead. Actually, we're in a different account, so we'll do the Fabricam feed. If you're a user of our Release Views feature that came out, I think, about a year ago, this is a feature where you can kind of subset your packages into views that are, you know, released or ready for consumption. You can filter notifications to just one of those views.
I can see why that would be really useful, because if you've got a build process which is producing a lot of packages,
exactly,
you don't want to get hit by too much noise.
Yep. And so, you know, as a package producer, if I say, you know, hey, I promoted this package to release, now you only get an email once a week instead of once every 20 minutes.
Fantastic. Okay, I like that feature.
So let's say, you know, I'll say packages from Fabricam release. Now this, of course, will tell me if there's any package in that feed that's promoted. Maybe I only care about a specific package. So I can choose package name, and I can enter any package that I want. So we'll say like CycleWorks, if that's a package that I have.
Okay.
I can just go ahead and click finish. And then anytime a new version of that package is published, I'll get a notification.
And so this works for NuGet, NPM, and Maven?
It does. It works for any package you store in package management. Okay. Now, another way to kind of stay up to date with packages is something that we call badges. If you've ever been to like a GitHub readme, you know those little squares you see up at the top? You see like my GitHub status, my NuGet package status.
Yep.
Yeah, so you're familiar with those. So we have those now in package management as well. So I'm going to click into my favorite demo package, my venerable bacon package. Makes me hungry every time. And I can just create a badge. So if I click in here, and you can see, again, we have integration with release views, so you can kind of show basically the latest version of the package in any view, or if you don't use views, just the latest version in the feed.
So why would I use a badge like this?
Yeah, so that's a great question. So if you have a readme, something on GitHub, I'm actually going to go put this on my project homepage in VSTS. It kind of makes it more of a one-stop shop for users. So instead of, you know, having to go and say, oh, well, I know there's a new build, so I'll go to builds. I know there's a new package, so I'll go to packages. It makes it so if I go to my project homepage, let's go back to my Fabricam Fiber home, you can see I already have a build badge here, so it's easy to click in and see the status of my build. And now if I add a package badge, right, and we'll pre-generate the markdown for you, so all you have to do is just paste it right in, and I'll go ahead and commit this. So now you can also see the latest version of my NuGet package. So if someone finds your package, your project in search, they just click on the NuGet badge and we'll take you right back to the package hub.
So when I produce a new version of that NuGet package within that feed, that number will update.
Exactly.
Okay. Awesome.
Right. So kind of two different ways of helping customers know that you've made a new version of a package available to them.
I like that. It's a great feature.
Awesome.
So what's next?
So we're going to switch gears a little bit now and talk about a feature we call Upstream Sources. Kind of a convoluted name, but really...
Sounds pretty scary.
You know, and certainly we hope it's not. What we wanted to do is make it possible to basically kind of collate all the packages that you use, whether from public sources, maybe even from other VSTS feeds if you're in a large organization, and bring them all into your feed with what we call provenance information. So it's like, hey, I know this came from over here, from NuGet.org or whatever, but I'm using it through my feed. Do things like save copies of packages. So if NPM goes down, if someone pulls a left pad and deletes a package off the public registry, your builds keep going.
Okay.
Right. So as long as VSTS is up and we have that enterprise-grade SLA and all that good stuff, then you can keep your builds running and your organization continues to be productive.
So it actually achieves a couple of things then. It simplifies the number of feeds you need to consume from, but it also helps make your build process more secure in terms of the upstream sources going offline.
Exactly.
Okay, fantastic.
Yeah. So we'll take a look at how to set one of those up. I'm going to come over here to my Fabricam feed. And so there's really two ways. If you're new to package management and you haven't gotten started with us yet, the first time you create a new feed, you'll see a new option down here as soon as this page warms up, where I can just say, hey, I would love to use packages from public sources. And so this is NuGet.org, npmjs.com. And when you create a feed like this, let's call this Mitch in honor of you. And I'll go ahead and click Create. Then all of my upstream sources are just wired up. As soon as I put this feed into my NuGet client, then I have access to everything that comes from NuGet.org automatically.
Okay.
Right. So if we go back and look at one of the feeds we were looking at earlier, we can actually see some of this in action. You can see these are all packages that I saved from npmjs at one point.
So you didn't manually publish these into your feed?
Exactly. Okay. Right. I connected to this feed just like this. So I said, you know, here, npm, know about my registry here. Go ahead and connect to that. And then when I ran, I think it was npm install express, right? A great front-end web framework. All the hundreds of dependencies that brought in, all now saved in my feed, all protected. Yep. Again, that continuous reliable build process.
That's right. And so those, once they're in your feed, those packages can't be replaced by the upstream source. They're kind of locked at that version.
Exactly. Okay. Right. And so now let's go back to Mitch's feed. We can see, if I hop into feed settings here briefly, we can see what that looks like. We'll just go to the upstream sources pivot. And you can see here I have an NPM, I have a NuGet.org, and now also add VSTS feeds. So if I have multiple feeds, it's a large organization, and I don't want to have to go and edit my NuGet config file all the time. I can just do it all server-side. One person can kind of take on the burden of saying, I want to use packages from these teams.
Okay, so there might be another team producing a library that your team consumes, but you only want to have one feed for your team.
Exactly.
Okay.
Right, kind of helps me manage all my dependencies in one place. So I can come to package management, I can see exactly what's going on. So in this case, our imaginary Contoso feed has some packages. You can see, just like before, heavily integrated with release views. So if you choose to use views, in this case, I'll say, hey, I only want to use packages from Contoso that they've kind of released.
Okay.
And actually, it's up to the feed producer to say, hey, this is the view that I'm making available to you.
Okay.
Some teams may choose to use what we call the local view. That's just all the packages in your feed. So you don't feel you have to use release views to get benefit out of upstream sources.
Okay.
But they definitely work better together.
Fantastic. Okay, I like that.
Perfect. So I can add that in, and then I'll just go ahead and save this. And just as before now, if I connect, I can install packages from the Contoso feed. They show up here again and have full, what we call provenance information showing where this package came from.
Great. And so the first time that I do a restore or an install via NuGet or NPM, that's when this all get populated.
Exactly.
And sometimes they'll come from the upstream sources.
Yep.
So is there anything, one of the issues with NuGet is that if you've got multiple feeds, it's hard to predict the order in which things will get installed. Does this help with that at all?
So it does, right? So kind of context for the audience. So every time NuGet exe runs, if you have multiple feeds in your NuGet config file, right, it just sends out requests to all of them, and whichever one comes back first wins. And so sometimes, especially at Microsoft, we actually see odd situations where people have customized packages, maybe pulled out DLLs they didn't think they needed, added DLLs they thought were better, and it was confusing. Sometimes you'd get one package, sometimes you'd get the other. With upstream sources, we guarantee you that as long as the feed that has those upstreams is the only feed in your config, you always get the same package you got the first time.
Okay, fantastic. I like it.
So now, kind of thinking on the other side of the package lifecycle, let's go back to one of my kind of bigger feeds here. I think there we go. We can actually jump into that. So sometimes we end up with a lot of versions of packages. As you mentioned, if I'm producing these in continuous integration, sometimes you can see I have 200 versions of this bacon package. I got a little eager as we were going along. And I don't need all this burden. It's a little bit of a pain to scroll through. And you can see that I've been good with release views. I've marked the packages that I'm actually using. So before, like, I could select these and I could certainly go and manually delete them and that would be great. But now we have a feature called retention policies where I can go into the feed settings and just kind of enter a number here and say, you know what, I only need, let's say, the last 20 versions of this package, right? And I'll click save. And the key thing here is anything I promoted to a view is exempt. We'll keep that forever. Okay. We assume that maybe you deployed it somewhere, maybe you shipped it, maybe you're like Windows and you need to keep it around for 10 years. And we're happy to do that for you. But that CI exhaust, what we call it, you don't have to keep that around.
Fantastic. That sounds really useful. So that means it keeps that view nice and tight in terms of the number of packages you're dealing with.
Exactly. And if kind of the whoops handle, if maybe we cleaned up something that you didn't want cleaned up, or maybe I'm just going to manually delete this package and I didn't mean to, and I ignored the red warning, everybody just clicks right through that. We've now added a recycle bin to the product. Kind of a basic feature, but definitely a nice to have where I can say, hey, you know, I really didn't mean to delete that package. I would really love to have it back. And now I can just restore it to the feed, you know, builds start working again, no panic, no having to kind of deal with new version numbers, any of that.
Okay, so that's all just put back the way it was.
Exactly,
okay.
Just like the Windows recycle bin, just like, go put it back, please.
Fantastic, perfect. That's awesome.
Yeah, so that's kind of the whirlwind tour. What'd you think?
That's a lot of things that have improved for people that are using package management, and I can see how those improvements will help improve the reliability of my engineering system and actually simplify it a lot as well. So. I think that's a fantastic set of features.
Awesome. Yeah, and I mean, package management honestly does best when it fades into the background. Like, we love you coming to our user experience, but at the end of the day, if packaging just works and you're sharing code and you're succeeding, that's really what we want to see.
Excellent. Well, thanks very much.
Yeah, absolutely. And we thank you for tuning in and watching, and we'll see you next time.